through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it. What's behind the gate?
Where will it take you?
It's not safe. Dillian, there he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go through before
he disappears.
Dillian, don't lose him.
Way too many times.
You always let
Where is he?
Where's he gone?
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one.
He's in the other one.
He's in the dark world.
Do you remember meeting him
in the dark the tree?
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
You can't go up
there.
Not in this world.
Do you think she remembers him?
Not in this world.
You can't.
You can't.
Senua, you've got it.
Why isn't he here?
He's gone.
He's in the dark world.
He's gone to the dark world.
The gods feast and rejoice. And amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Baldur's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young." Oh dear.
He cared in a way that nobody else did.
Look what
Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Baldur. The blind god, Huth, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Huth says, "I cannot see where Baldur stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon." Loki replies, "Here is a wand. I will tell you where he stands." And Hoth throws the mistletoe at Baldur. It pierces through him, and to everyone's horror, Baldur is killed. And for this, Hurd is slain.
Everything gets broken in the end.
You've killed him with your love because he believed in you.
Dillion doesn't know who killed him, but we do.
Has claimed Dillion.
Poor Dillion. He didn't know he was kind. He saw that she was strong. Do you remember what it was to touch him?
Dillion undoes the curse.
What does it feel like to feel a love so strong?
The gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?"
Look what happens to the things you love.
Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Baldur. The blind god, Hurd, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hurd says, "I cannot see where Baldur stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon." Loki replies, "Here is a wand."
Years had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dillion. She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, movement. And in intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds. That of Zinbel and her past, and Dillian, her future. Two realities tearing at her soul.
Husband, and the pyre is lit, sending the dead to hell. But even so, the gods cannot accept his death.
She thought she had light within her when she was unleashed. You have no time for this. Speed up. Trials to distract you. You set you up, and now they're going to watch you. What if these trials mean nothing? Gods can see laughing at you. But if they take you no closer to Dillian? Perhaps Dillian, you're letting this get in the way. What if they are just to tire you out? Make you weak before the battle. It's all your fault. You're cursed. He was kind to her.
Was it worth it?
You're still alive and Dillian's dead. He doesn't deserve to be dead.
How does that make you feel?
He was the only one she could trust.
Could she trust him?
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see what is truly missed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur. Weep him out of hell. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees, metal, everything. Except for a giantess they find in a cave. Baldur was never my friend, she says. Let Hel keep what she has. The Northmen say that the giantess must have been Loki in disguise.
He was the only one that didn't mind the curse.
He loved her so much.
She should have listened to her.
Why didn't she listen to her?
She thought she could do it.
Northmen tell how the gods punished Loki for Baldur's death. They captured him and took him to a cave. They fetched his two sons and turned one into a wolf, and he ripped his brother apart. The gods used Loki's own son's entrails to tie him down and turned these bonds to iron and dangled a poisonous serpent over his face so that its venom would drip onto him. Each time the venom drips onto Loki's face, he writhes in agony. The Northmen say that is the cause of earthquakes.
In a way that nobody else did. Dillian saved her.
You owe your life to Dillian.
You owe everything to him.
if they're all about wasting your time, just delaying minute by minute by minute. What does she think she's doing? You're not special. She thinks she can.
They mean nothing.
Gods are just toying, playing. What if the gods are laughing at her?
You're messing with her.
It would be
the worst time. To you.
Dillian never much cared for the underworld, and looked dimly upon the druids, like her father, Zinbel. I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see. And he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillian's arms, glad to see the world through his eyes. And slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
You're going to fall, Kev.
No, she's not. She's not going to fall. She's strong. She's steady. She can do it. You can do it, Sinwa.
Father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? You give up the beautiful world that you, and only you, can see just to be rid of your nightmares. Or is this the price you pay for the gift you have? The gift that makes you so special in my eyes. Just another part of the person I love.
I left for the wilds to protect you from my darkness. Because I love you. But it made it worse. I'm so sorry.
It's done. You did it. But there's more. Go in. There's more. You're tired, but you have to keep going. There's still more.
There's always more to do.
It's not going to be easy.
Say that their all-father, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Where am I? I can't see.
Shh.
Can you hear me?
Dillian.
I'm right here. Can't you see me?
No. Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. Then there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from.
Yes, you can.
The others. The voices. They've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet. So dark.
It's okay. Listen to your own breath. Feel it rise and fall. Good. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
can't go on. Lillian?
Find a way. I'm not leaving you here.
I think I'm somewhere else now. But the breeze has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Good.
I've reached the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow it upstream.
I'm so sorry. I thought I left this all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of me. It won't let me go.
Senua. My father. He taught me that the hardest battles are fought in the mind, not the soul. You're no coward. You proved that in the Warrior Triumph. This is just another battle. You can beat it.
This isn't your battle. You don't have to help me.
I want to. Besides, you are going to be a great warrior one day. You need to be right.
Okay. I'll do my best. Go on this way.
Then look for another way and tell me what you find.
There is a house.
Don't be afraid.
Dillian, there's something in here.
Do you see it?
No.
Then it cannot see you. Quietly move past it, one step at a time.
It's not following me.
Leave it behind and keep moving forwards.
There is more of them. I think they're moving.
You're breathing too fast.
I'm scared.
Listen to the sound of your breath. In and out. In and out. You can do this, Senua.
I think I'm in a house. It stinks. Of death.
The darkness is testing you. But you are in control.
As well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
Tilly, help me.
She could spend hours, days even, trapped within herself, in the dark.
You see me?
Yes.
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere, with no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
What if this is pointless? What if you're wrong? What if this is the end?
It's just a trick. It's just a pointless test.
You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again.
You're being tested.
You don't know. It's just their game for you.
You never know which way it's going to go.
I saw once a plague strike northern lands of ice. It was so terrible that not the oldest man among us could remember the like. Hundreds died. The sickness took nearly every person younger than 40 and many older. And where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
Where are we? I don't like it.
This place feels...
What is this place?
This place feels... It's... creepy.
Creepy.
It feels wrong.
It feels strange. Where is it? Where are we?
Turn back.
This is wrong. This has to be wrong.
This place stinks.
Ah. It's disgusting.
It smells like...
Oh, I can't breathe.
Can you smell the death?
Oh.